This video is brought to you by Storyblogs Video. Chroma keying in Hollywood films has always intrigued me. Every time I see one of those behind-the-scenes videos, I keep wondering, how the hell did they pull off that green key? You know, from what I've learned, you should always avoid wrinkles in your green screen, make sure it's evenly lit and that your talent is definitely not wearing any green. And then you see these behind-the-scenes of big Hollywood films where it seems that they don't care about those things. I mean, look at these guys from the Godzilla film. Green soldiers, one of them is holding a green bazooka in front of a green screen. Still, they're able to pull off a perfect key from that. Or this shot here, which comes from an incredible music video by Leningrad. Did they simply throw that green screen there from a distance? I mean, how many shades of green can you have? So then what's the secret? At this point, I still don't know, and I want to figure it out. And the fact that you're watching this video means that I did found some really useful tips, so let's see what they are. Hey folks, Jordy here for CineCan.net and welcome to Creative Tuesday. But today I want to figure out how to pull the perfect key. So to do that, we got Janik in a green army suit, and he's also going to wear a blonde wig and of course hold a gun to make it look real. Now, the idea is to pull a key with one simple click in post-production and maybe do some minor adjustments, but that's it. We want to focus on the stuff that we can do during the shoot to make the keying go easier. Now before we start with that, I'd first like to make a big shout out to our sponsor Storyblogs Video. Their incredible library is packed with After Effects templates, transitions, effects like explosions, muzzle flashes, and so much more. And if you're gonna pull a green key, then you're gonna need a background for that. Storyblogs got you covered again with your high quality 4K stock clips and backgrounds. So make sure to click the first link in the description below to learn more on how you can download unlimited video assets from their incredible library. Tip number one, let's go over all the basics first. To start off, you want to make sure that your green screen is tight. That means no wrinkles that will only create shadows. And yes, big productions don't always seem to care about that, but we'll get into that later. Next up is lighting. Don't make hot spots or gradients. Do your best to have the same intensity of lighting across the entire green screen. Tools like Feltz Color or even the simple waveforms can help with that. A curved line means that you have a hotspot, so move your lights around until you have a straight line on your waveform. Your green screen should be considered as a zone, and your subject should not come in that zone, or else the green will spill on your talent. We talk about creating two zones, one for the green screen and one for the other lighting setup that is for your talent. And finally is the shutter speed. The motion blur is very hard to key, so by setting a faster shutter speed, you can reduce that motion blur. Now, of course, you do have to understand that that will also change the look and feel of your shots. So those were the basics. When you got those things right, you're starting off with a solid setup. Tip number two, this one and the next tip is something that I got from KineTech, probably the most underrated channel here on YouTube. If you actually want to learn something from cinematography, then just stop watching us and check out this channel. No, please don't. Mathieu, the guy behind KineTech, talked about the luminance of the green. Every color has a specific luminance value, like yellow sits above 60%, red a little above 20%, and green is about 45%. Now that is true green and will give you the least interference with other colors or even other tints of green. Here you can see Janik with his green suit. Currently on the waveform, we can see that the background and the suit comes in each other luminance value. So by making the background brighter, we can lift that green to above 40%. After that, we decrease the intensity of the lights on the talent, which as you can see, separates the two greens. At the same time, we'll also have a better green from the green screen. Now there are a few exceptions that we found through some tests where you could make your green screen darker or maybe brighter. Hair is always the hardest to key. Definitely blonde hair is a nightmare. So the idea is to make a big contrast between the blonde hair and the green screen. Now we can't change much about the colors, but we can change the luminance value. So I'm dropping the green to 30%, making it darker. Against the brighter blonde hair, this actually worked out pretty good. Tip number three, again, your green screen should be green. This time I'm opening up the vector scope. Now many DSLRs like the GH5 or external monitors like the one from Small HD have these tools built in. If you don't have that, you could always film a short clip and look at the vector scope in Premiere or something. There's also an app called Green Screener, which gives you a ton of different tools to help set up a green screen. Now, I haven't used it myself yet, but it has some good reviews. Now you want to make sure that the highlight on your vector scope leans towards the green. If it's not the case, then check your white balance. If it's not set according to the type of lights that you're using, you will capture a different mix of green. You can also change the tint value if necessary. Just be careful that you don't overdo this, as you still want your subjects to look natural. And if you keep having trouble getting the highlight into green, then you might need to look for a different green screen. That's why I would always suggest you purchase a green screen that is specifically meant for video. Don't just buy a fabric at a carpet store or something. The next tip is going to be post-related, but I want to show you exactly how easy the keying will go once you got the shooting right. Now, we did several tests using the Ultra Key effect from Premiere Pro. Then we tried out two paid plugins. One was $300 and the other one $500, which I've requested a refund from because I was getting the best results with Key Light from After Effects. Now, this is a built-in effect, so everyone has it. Now, if you search for the key light effect, you will actually find a preset for it. Applying this to your clip will also add a key cleaner and a spill suppression to it. Now, I always thought that it didn't really matter where you clicked with the color picker, but apparently it is pretty important. This is a tip that I got from Jason Levine, who also worked at Adobe. What you want to do is locate your composition and layer window. Drag them so that they lay next to each other. Then change the view in your layer window to anchor point path. And then change the view in your key light effect to status. When you now hold down your Alt key while moving the color picker around, you can see in real time what the key light effect is selecting. And even by moving one pixel, you can see how different each selection is. You want to try to get as much black to cover the green, and then you click. And this will give you a very solid key. You can then fine-tune a bit more using the clip black and white, but I would suggest you stay off the shrink and softness settings. Now, these are settings that you should only use when the keying doesn't work so well, because in the end, it will only mess up your edge, so it's best to stay off from that. Finally, we have the key cleaner, which is gonna add a transparent stroke over the edge, and this one works great with blonde hair. And finally is the spill suppressor, which is gonna remove any unwanted green. We didn't even have to touch those, but you can dial into the details if you'd like so. And here we did again the exact same thing on the shot with Janik, wearing the green suit and waving his blonde hair. Now, it's definitely not perfect, we're still kind of learning ourselves, but considering this is a very hard key to pull, I think that we did a pretty good job. And that brings me to the last tip. Now, whenever you're gonna work with tracking marks on your green screen, I see many bigger productions use something like red. Now, I still really haven't figured out why that color in particular is gonna be more helpful, probably because of the contrast, which will make the tracking go easier, but you can't really key it out since red comes back in the skin tones. So we did the test. We used green tape that has a different tint of green than the backdrop. We added a few dots and did a camera movement. Then in After Effects, I simply clicked on the 3D camera tracker and it worked. This allowed me to link my new background to one of the points. And there we have it, Janik enjoying his vacation in his green suit and blonde hair. So that was it again for today. I learned a ton of new things and I really hope that you did too. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Storyblocks Video for the support. And as always, stay creative. And we tried out two paid plugins. One was $300. When you want to say buck and dollar at the same time, you get duck.
Jordy, we can't pay our bills with ducks. It has to stop, Jordy!